right, so I've got the large CNC machine set up to cut a job, and that job is this. The back will be similar to this, not exactly the same. This was a 3D printed prototype. We're going to test cut it in plastic first, and then ultimately we want to make it out of aluminum because it's going to be this, and we want the back to be a heat sink. These lights I specifically designed and made them tiny to where I can hide them up under the spindle or, you know, off to the side a little bit, but direct light underneath the spindle. It just helps to see what the bit's doing. It makes for better videos. So that's what I'm working on. And I'll show you how to make it start to finish. We're going to CAD it. We're going to cam it. We're going to cut it on the machine. And we'll have to tap the hole on the back of it for an M5. And I'll show you the electronics that are involved. So this is going to be a really easy but really useful start to finish project that, you know, has lots more uses other than just CNC, whether you just need accent lighting or under the counter lighting or reading lights or special effects at Halloween, whatever. You could use this, so stick around and let's get started.
All right, so this is going to be our next installment in a start to finish series, and to do this, you've probably already seen the intro on what we're going to be working on. And so to design this part, we're actually going to do this inside of onshape. Now, for those of you that don't know, onshape is a online, if I can spell it correctly, online CAD program. And it's the website says it's still in beta, but it's fully usable. We're going to go ahead and sign in with my account here, so just give me a second. And while that's coming up, we'll talk about it. So, onshape, like I said, onshape is an online web CAD tool, and it's parametric. You can design parts, you can adjust them by size, you can, you know, if you draw a lineal that's 12 inches and now you need to draw one that's 24 inches, you can just go in and edit that part and change the extrusion from 12 inches to 24 inches, and there it goes. You don't have to do anything else to it. You don't have to redraw the whole part. So it makes, a recent example is the CNC table that I use on my KR33 CNC machine. It was a 12 by 12 by 1/2 on the first machine. The second machine is going to be roughly 16 by 16 by 1/2. And I was able to take the original file and just through parametric CAD just go in and say, okay, the dimension is not 12 by 12, it's actually 16 by 16, enter, and it scaled it out. So it makes modification and, you know, mating parts together, it makes that very easy. So we're inside onshape now. I'm looking at my documents window for my recently opened files, and up in the top right hand corner you see the LED can 1, and that's what we're working on. This is going to be the design for a not complicated part, but it's going to be a very useful part, not only for my CNC machine, but if someone could use it for under the cabinet lighting, you could use it for a reading light for your kids, or for yourself, accent lights, you name it, Halloween props, Christmas items, whatever your imagination decides to do with it. So I did a teaser where I showed a couple of pieces of plastic stock and aluminum stock as well, and that's what this is for. This is a 1-inch diameter part. It's not even an inch long, and we're going to, as you can see by the picture, we're going to use the back of this as an additional heat sink. I don't know that the LEDs actually require a heat sink. They already have an aluminum backer on the circuit board, so it has somewhat of a heat sink built into it, but this is just going to add more cooling capacity to the LED since it will be sealed up on the front side, and it also gives us a very handy place to put an M5 screw, in this case right in the center of the back of it. So we're going to start drawing this. Of course, I'd already done one already in onshape, and we're just going to walk through it again. So I'm just going to create a new file. We're going to say this one's LED can, let's say just 2, so we'll hit OK. So if you've never used SolidWorks or Inventor, Fusion, lots of other CAM programs out there, or CAD programs out there, this is very similar to the others. You're looking at the different planes that you have available to you. You've got front, right, and top. So typically what I like to do is I want to work off the front plane, and let's make that normal too. I just double clicked on the front over in the top right, and the first thing we need to do is I'm going to draw the circular profile of the entire part. So this is simply just a circle. So if I can find my we're going to do a sketch. So yes, sketch plane, that's fine. We're going to use the front as the sketch plane. So now our options come up. So I'm going to use a center point circle just to make the and what I certainly want here, I'm just making the round stock, basically, if you will, that we're going to start from. So I'm going to click on the centermost, the origin, basically, and I'm just going to arbitrarily click out to something. And so we have a circle. So big deal, right? So we need to tell it how big that circle is, because I kind of like to keep up with it. So I just went up to the dimension tool here. I'm going to click on the outside of the circle, and it's going to say, okay, you were, you know, 0.291 off of 1 inch. So I'm just going to double click that and hit 1. So now it's a 1 inch circle. So if we rotate it in space here, wrong button, you can see that we have a little flat circle. So that's exactly what we wanted. So now we need to give that some depth to create the body of this LED can. So I'm going to use the extrude here. I'm going to click on that. And right now it's saying blind, but and that's fine. And it's saying, okay, how far do you want to extrude it? By default, it came up to 1 inch. Well, I know from designing the other one that we actually need this to be 0.762. And I'll hit enter and hit the check there. So now we have depth to the part. And I am seeing that it actually extruded it forward, and that's not really what I wanted. So let's go back and fix that. So I've got extrude over here. I can edit. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to change the direction that it extruded that. So I want to extrude that back. So I'll click that and I'll hit OK. So now let's look at it again. So now we actually have depth to the part. So we pushed it backwards instead of bringing it forwards. So that's really what I was looking for. All right, so now that we have the main body extruded, we are going to start working on the front side. The front's going to be where the LED is going to sit, and we're going to have to create a pocket for the LED, but also a ledge for the lens to sit on. So let's start with the lens. So we're going to go do a sketch, and the sketch plane, we actually want to sketch off of this surface of the part here. So we'll go, and we need a center point circle again. We'll choose the center. We'll just pull it out to some approximate location. Use our dimension tool. Click on the outside, and this needs to be 0.91 inches. So there we go. So now we need to make that a pocket. Now the lens on this could be acrylic, polycarbonate. If you had a way to do it, you could make it out of glass, or even frosted acrylic or polycarbonate, just to make it more of a diffuser effect. But that's going to need to be, or at least the way that I'm going to draw it, is going to be 1/8 of an inch depth. So we'll need to extrude cut this to a depth of 1/8 of an inch, or 0.125. So we're going to do 0.125 there. And we know we need to cut this into the part, so I know I need to flip it. And up here in onshape, this is where you, well, let me back up. To compare it to some other of the CAD programs, you would extrude cut, or you would just extrude. There's one extrude function on onshape, and you just need to select what it's going to be. And so here we're actually going to remove material. So I'll select remove. I've got my dimension in there, and let's cock this a little bit and see if we're going in the right way. And it's doing a preview, so we are correct there. So we'll hit OK. So now we have created the 1/8 of an inch depth here that the lens is going to sit into. So the lens will be flush with the front of the aluminum body. Let me bring that back to the front. So now we're going to move on to the actual depth, or the pocket, that the LED itself is going to sit into. So this will be another sketch, and this time we're going to sketch off of the bottom of the existing hole. So here we're going to use the same circle tool. We'll go to the center and we'll go out to some number. I know this needs to be 0.85, so we'll dimension this. We were close, 0.85, like so. Don't need much of a ledge for that lens to sit on, so I think that's going to be a plenty. And again, we're going to extrude this. And we need to remove. And our depth is going to be, I believe it's 0.413. That might actually be including the eighth of an inch, but we'll figure that out here in a second. We need to make sure we're going the right way. that actually looks too deep to me. That's probably the whole depth. Because we need a quarter of an inch on the back side so that we can do all the heat sink operations. So let's put onshape to the test here. I haven't tried this, but I know that in other programs you could do this. So can you do that? No, it doesn't like that. Probably because of the inch. Here we go. So it did work. So I basically had the 413, which is what we figured out was the entire pocket depth, not just from the ledge lip down. That was actually too far. So what I did was, in the line where I'm specifying the depth, I just went ahead and did the math. I told it to do 0.413 minus the eighth of an inch for the lens ledge, and it did it. So that worked out great. So I have seen that in other programs. You just had to remove the inch symbol off of there. So there is our LED pocket. Not complicated, but if you're new to CAD, hopefully this is showing you just how easy this can be. Once you get familiar with the semantics of the software, really your own imagination is the biggest limit that you've got. Alright, so we do need to do a side hole, and I actually forgot how far that was going to be down, but let's try it. So we'll go ahead and do that part of it. So let's see if we do, let's look at the right side. And alright, so we're gonna blast a hole through the side of this thing. Sorry about that. We're gonna blast a hole through the side, so we're gonna do sketch. And we're gonna sketch on the right plane. I didn't like that. So let's say, there we go. Alright, so I want to do a center point circle. And it's, I'm guessing here, we're gonna put it like right there. And let's dimension that to an eighth of an inch. So we're a little fat there, 1.125, go. And we need to add another dimension. I want to dimension it from the top, or actually I could dimension it from this plane to this point. And that's telling us that's 0.25. If we know that the bottom of the hole is 0.413, let's just do 0.3 and see where that gets us. And I want to extrude, cut that, remove it. Let's see which direction we're going in. So it sketched it off the right plane, which was actually center. So it's actually sketching from the inside of the part, and we're blowing a hole through the outside of the part. That actually works out quite nice. So we can see here that we've got a little bit of room at the bottom. And so, you know, I can leave that an inch because it really doesn't matter because it's cutting out in the air. So let's do OK on that. But what I want to do is I want to go back and I want to edit this sketch, because I want to take this dimension here and let's move it down 0.31 and see what that looks like. We can go even further than that. Let's do 0.325. Hit OK. And I actually like that, because leaving a little bit of a lip is fine because the circuit board is going to be sitting on this back face right here. And so we're going to solder the two wires that need to come in through the side and land on the LED chip itself. And so it will be raised up a little bit. So this will probably work just fine. So that's perfectly fine. So we're done with that part. So let's go back and look at the front. All right, so over here in the tree, you can see everything that we're doing. It's got a sketch, and then it's got the feature that we do after that. So sketch extrude, we're basically doing the same thing over and over again. And you can delete any of these features. You can roll them back to minus up. So you kind of have a history of what you've done, and it makes it very easy. So we are done with the front of this part. I'm not going to worry about any chamfers or any sort of cosmetics at this point. So we need to look at the back. So let's look at the back of this bad boy. So this is where we get into some seriousness here. And I'm not going to show all of this because once we kind of do a half or a quadrant, the rest of it's really going to be easy. A few of the features that come in very handy here are offsets and mirror. And let's just start with the simplest feature that we need on the back of this, and that's going to be the hole on the back. And this is going to be for an M5 screw, which is typically what my accessories are. This could easily be a quarter 20 for an M5. Well, let's just get to that. So we're going to sketch off the back of this. We need a center point circle. Just draw something. Let's dimension that. Since I'm doing an M5, I know from past experience. Now, notice that it's in inches here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to do 4.2 and then mm for millimeters. And it will automatically convert that to inches. And that's going to be the tap size for an M5 standard size bolt. And we are going to leave that alone. I could go ahead and extrude cut that and go ahead actually, you know what? Let's just go ahead and do that. So we've got our hole. Let's go ahead and extrude. Remove. We need to watch which direction. Okay, that's fine. We're going to do a quarter of an inch, 0.25, and we'll hit OK. So let's see where that lands. So we didn't blow it all the way through. We've got plenty of meat there, so that's good. And that's pretty much what I was looking for. All right, so back to the back. Okay, so what we could have done is we could have gone ahead and drawn all the fins as well, and we could extrude cut all of it at the same time. And why not? Let's do that. We'll just back it up. So we got the extrude here, so let's go back to the sketch. We'll edit the sketch. And so now we can add all these other features. So let me show you the mirror feature. Well, a couple of things, actually. So let's do a line. So we're going to do line, and I want to do it from here to somewhere out here. We'll hit escape there. And let's dimension that line. We're going to go from here to here. And I know that I want that to be 45. So we'll say OK. Just type in 45. And so let's just work on part of a quadrant. So we'll run down this line right here, and I know that I want the width of this channel we're going to cut into this. It needs to be greater than 0.125 because I'm going to use an 1/8 inch end mill to cut this pocket. I typically don't like to have it so close, like only a couple of thou over. So we'll make it a little bit bigger than that. So here's one of the things we can do. Actually, I want to do offset. So I'm going to click on that little crazy looking offset there, and I'm going to click on this line. And I know I want that offset to be, I know what I want the hole width to be. I know I want it to be 0.165. We're just going to divide that by 2. So there's our 0.83. So if I come and do offset again on this line, Alright, so I created these two lines. And I want these two lines to actually be I'll take that back. I don't want that to be constructed. Alright, so Now I want to make a circle. Don't really know where that came from. I need to put my line back. So I'll select this, offset 0.083. There we go. Okay, so I want to do a circle, center point. And I'm going to use this middle line that I had drawn earlier. I'm going to click on it and I'm going to drag it out. So you see there, it's got a little tangent symbol kind of floating around right there. That's exactly what I want. So that means it brought that circle out to meet the line at 0.083. And I know that I need to dimension that. This will all make sense in a minute, so just bear with me. We're going to dimension this out. And this particular one is going to be 0.25. Okay, that's good. So now I'm going to pull out some clippers. And I'm going to clip this because we don't need that. I'm going to clip this, 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 this. Now, another thing that you can do is actually draw these lines for construction. So this is really what I was going for here. So let's see. So now that I've got that, let's mirror this thing. So, and what mirroring is basically, I want to take this feature, these drawings, these lines. It doesn't have to be a completed anything, but I want to take these things and I want to flop them over to this side. So I'm gonna select that, and where's my mirror? There's mirror. I'm gonna select that. It says select a mirror line. I'm gonna select this. So now we just flopped it over to the other side. So that's perfect, exactly what I wanted. And the other thing I need to do is I need to draw the outside circle. And I could just draw it anywhere. Let's dimension that. And what this is going to be kind of like my boundary. So that's the exact same size as the other one. So what I'm trying to do is I'm like, okay, well, what are we actually going to extrude, cut out of this part? So let me go back to my scissors. Okay. So now, I hope I didn't do that too fast, but for now, so that's exactly what I did. What I had to do was, yes, I drew this open contour, and I've run into this too many times. And it sometimes if your dimensions or your numbers are not right, the system will come back and say, I can't extrude that, I can't extrude cut that, I can't extrude, you know, positively extrude that, because you have an open contour. And so what I did was I drew the circle that covered the entire outside, and I cut everything away except this bridge between here, this point and this point, and this point and this point, because that made a pocket here and a pocket there to match the closed contour circle here, and so it extrude cut that into the back of the part. So let's go back and edit that sketch, and this time let's just go for the gusto here. I'm going to select those. I don't want that one. So I hit shift and then I just clicked on it to deselect it. And let's mirror it again. Select a mirror line. Sure, why not? Now we have four of them. Okay. And so since it grabbed the closed contours, we can hit, okay, that looks good. So now we have that. The only additional thing that I want to do to this is I want to cut out a smaller cut here, 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 and here, and that's going to give me just more cooling, basically. This is all symmetrical. So you get the idea. So we could easily do the same thing. I could draw my offset lines here, making them 0.165 wide, and I won't sink them as far into the center as I did these. They'll actually be probably somewhere right here, because I don't want to take away too much material. But that's what we do. So technically, that's kind of it. We kind of made the part, except for these other little features on here. So I'm going to go ahead and draw them. We may include this in the final video. We may not, but we'll just go ahead and finish it out. So we'll go back to sketch number 5, edit that sketch, and let's draw a line first. So we'll draw a line like so, hit escape. I'm going to select that line. I'm going to do offset. And we know 0.083. And I'm going to select this line again and drag this guy this way. And I need a circle. Does it really matter? Make sure it's tangent there. And this time we need to change the dimension that it is from the center. So here to here. Always be sure that the dot, you see the dot on the origin, is lit. Always make sure you're grabbing the right spot. Alright, so 0.425, let's say. Not what I want. So let's see. What do we want there? How about 0.35? What's that look like? Nah, we could go more than that. 0.375. Whoa, wrong way, Dave. 0.325. All right, I like that, 0.3. Okay, so what do we need to do now? We need to cut here, 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 there. Okay. Let's go ahead and do one right here as well. So we need a line. Let's select that line, offset 0.083. Offset. Circle. And we need to dimension. We did 0.3. And so for the sake of doing this twice, I'm going to delete these, because what I'm going to do is I'm going to end up drawing that circle again. But first, I want a line, but I want a construction line. So let's that converts it. All right, so let's do this.
want that to be 45 degrees from here. And I'm going to try something here. Perfect. All right, I need to draw my circle again. All right, so now we've basically created all these funky contours now that we've got to correct. And so the way I'm going to do that, we want to leave all these pockets closed, and we want to remove any line segment that is in between the pockets. While I'm doing this, I can go ahead and trim these as well. So we only want the pockets to remain intact. Okay, that should be everything. So if we hit go here, now we have the back of it. That should be pretty good heat sink, I think. Looks kind of cool. And so, you know, a lens for this would be really easy. It would just be a disc that's an eighth of an inch thick. All right, so there you have it. So with this, you know, you could save this as an STL file if you have access to a 3D printer, or you have a 3D printer. You could test print one of these and mock it up, make sure that everything fits correctly, and do that kind of work before you set up a CNC job or do the CAD or the CAM to the part, and figure out how you're going to hold it and all those types of things. Since this is 1-inch bar stock, whether it's plastic or aluminum, I have a 5C collet holder, and we're just going to put this in the 5C collet and work on it that way. The fixture will fit on the actually either one of my CNC machines that I currently have running, and we're going to test this thing and see what we can make it look like. Hopefully sometime in the near future we'll be able to do some engraving on the outside of this. So that'll be coming up. So if you have any questions about this, let me know. This is the design part of this series, and we will be moving on to how we're going to CAM this, create the tool paths to cut it, select the tooling, tolerances, all of that, and then we'll move on to actual cutting of the part. Probably test cut first, and then we'll roll into the aluminum version next. So appreciate everybody watching. And if you have any questions, always hit me up at questions@neo7cnc. And if you're enjoying these videos and can support the Neo7 CNC channel, be sure to click on the Patreon link below. Thank you for your time, and we will talk to you soon.